They say the Supreme Court on Tuesday carried the hearing of Emeka Ehiduor applicant to MC Take say may they review the January 14, 2020 judgment when MC they take pursue him as Imo State Governor come put Hope Uzodinma for in place go front. The seven-man panel of the Apex Court when MC the Chief Justice of Niger, Justice Tanko Muhammad, Isidan Asoga, he carried the hearing go front after Ehiduor lawyer Kanu Agabi son he tell the court say they still defy the process them. The lawyer when MBC stand for Uzodinma and the party, the All Progressive Congress, Damian Dodo, San, and the one when MBC the Independent National Electoral Commission, Tamini Nuwa San, therefore, he not oppose the applicant when MBC that he carried the matter go front. The CJN-led panel carried the matter go front in March 2nd for hearing. All right, with us we get our Ogbonge lawyer when MBC they follow us to slide the matter. His name is Liborous Oshoma, and I welcome him on top Plus TV Africa.
Good to you, my brother.
Now you try a pass. All right, we'll get some questions on top of this Ehiduor matter. The first one, we say the Supreme Court, they say they don't adjourn this case from today, so go March 2nd. You expect this judgment?
Normally, now the lawyers say that they see the five papers.
Yeah.
So if they see the five papers, when Supreme Court won't hear, Supreme Court get option but to adjourn the matter.
Oh, okay.
So because now the way they won't take decide the matter, it never did before them.
Okay.
So that's why the Supreme Court adjourned the matter. Nobody say
they just carry.
Do them. No.
Okay. So a follow process.
Then the procedure be that.
All right. The second one is they say he surprised. He said the adjournment now because of the instance of the counsel to Ehiduor and the PDP can when be saying name be Kanu Agabi San to make them. On top of the party to conclude the process when MBC said that they file and when MBC said they serve.
No, it surprised me really because the way when they shout since you go to say by now they don't put all their papers together and all the papers on there before the Supreme Court. And so nobody said today where Supreme Court already.
Yeah.
Because you know over this matter they protest.
Yes.
Over this matter they shout, we don't go court, we don't file application for review and the rest. And then the be like the antelope for Chinua Achebe book when dance itself lame before the main dance.
Yeah.
Then on the day of the dance now you say, ah, I beg, I never ready, I still get paper when I define.
Okay.
So the thing surprised me. I think say now the other lawyers will say, ah, we just receive paper now, we need to respond.
Okay.
But that not be the case. But anyway, now so they be.
Okay, no wahala. For the request, they say now waste of time. And be say as a matter they call annul them on top of the likelihood of some surprise decision from the Supreme Court. On top of the matter, when they say they take. So how you say this matter?
I don't understand you. See,
they say the request, that waste of time.
Yeah, Supreme Court said the request for today.
Request
for adjournment or the
request when they say they take carry the case go front. So.
Not ordinarily. If you look the way I look this matter, some people say a waste of time, but I don't believe in a waste of time.
Okay.
I believe say the two parties. Self in the first place, not even meet the requirement of the law.
Okay.
And so since they don't meet the requirement of the law, the Supreme Court not even supposed to wait to make anybody call them. Then because by the time they allow the parties file application, the parties go put it matter when even the Supreme Court don't decide on before.
Okay.
So for me, the Supreme Court supposed to just call all the parties, say, you know what? The declaratory order where we give.
Yeah.
Be like say the law of the land, the constitution, no support that order.
Okay.
So to that extent, we will come out one leg from that order, but all the other ones stand.
Okay. All right, the fourth one, they say the Supreme Court, they say they don't do work well. They don't consistent on top of their matter, they say they grant. So for this ruling, for recent time. So looking at the case of Imo and Payesa.
Yes, if you look the Imo case, first and foremost, INEC in the first place also know they're consistent.
Okay.
Supreme Court also know they're consistent. Because for somebody to become governor for Nigeria, the requirement of the constitution are section 179, subsection 2, you go score the highest number of votes, and then you go score 1/4, that's 25% of the vote when they cast, for at least 2/3 of the local government for the state. For Ehiduor, now only 14 local government out of 27, and 14 no reach 2/3, 18 might be 2/3.
Okay.
For Uzodinma, only 2. So person when no get 14, when get 14, when no reach 18, we say no meet the spread. Now the person when can't get 2,
now
you can't carry and give. So what do you mean, be say? Supreme Court just look the highest number.
Yes.
They don't look the other leg, because for you to be governor, you must use two legs stand.
Okay.
You will score the highest number, then you will get the spread. Okay. And so them no look the spread. And so that is why that one is very important.
Okay.
Then for that the Bayelsa own. The Bayelsa own, the thing when Bayelsa teach us, we say, for section 187, for section 187 subsection 1, for you to become governor also, when they nominate you, INEC no go accept your nomination if you no get running mate.
Mm-hmm.
Once you no get running mate, your name no go enter paper.
Yeah.
And then if you look section 31, subsection 6 of the Electoral Act, he say, if you submit affidavit when they wrong, the court gets power to invalidate your nomination.
Okay.
And so by that section, what did the court just simply do now to invalidate that nomination? Say the affidavit where the man give it they wrong. And by section 87, subsection 10 of the Electoral Act, anybody when face a candidate, aspirant when face a candidate not meet the requirements of fee go court to challenge that process. But people don't they quote section 140, subsection 1 and 2 of the Electoral Act say, by virtue of that section, anybody, if I court invalidates any candidate,
they're
not supposed to declare the next person winner. They suppose ask for a rerun.
Yeah.
But Justice Kola Wole, as far back as 2015 or so, invalidate that section 140, subsection 1 and 2, say it take away the powers of the court to use their discretion.
Okay.
And so that section, as we did today, they know they exist for our law book.
Okay.
Like I said, they cancel the section for our law book. So that is why the Supreme Court do what it then do for Bayelsa. So what do we suppose they advise people now be say, not just wait on the day of election, go thumbprint. You also need to torchlight the candidate when you want thumbprint for whether truly this candidate meets the requirement, or whether make it not be say you thumbprint for and tomorrow they can't invalidate her. Political parties also need to begin to torchlight their candidate so that you go get be say you go bring the candidate when go not only they acceptable but he meet the requirement.
He meet all the requirements.
You know, so that tomorrow, you know, go be say after you don't win election.
The
person an Awayo, or the candidate know they you know meet the requirement. Yeah. And then lastly, what we suppose they push for now that be say every pre-election matter, it good make we end pre-election matter before we even do election.
Okay.
So that you go know say every candidate. No baggage. Just like when you want to buy property, you will go check whether the property get baggage.
Yeah.
So if you want to vote for Percy, good may we also clear all the pre-election matter. And then also good may we clear all post-election matter before swearing in. So once we do that, anybody won't get baggage, they go don't decide them even before going to election.
Mm.
And who no win election, they go don't decide them even before swearing in. So with that, nobody don't occupy office when no be on.
All right, thank you very much. We will come back to you, but we'll just go this morning still.